Shalom, shalom, shalom. Pastor Blaine, welcome back again. We're going to be continue part two from last week. Last week, we have covered so many things. What does that mean to be saved? Saved from what? And also, we established that to be saved means it doesn't mean changing your religion. It is having relationship with Christ. We also established that when someone comes to Christ, it is not changing the religion. It is a change from inside out. And today we will continue a different path. The best example is Apostle Paul, how he came to Christ and how he was before and after he came to Christ, his life has been really a big change. Pastor Blaine, can you briefly explain how was Apostle Paul before and after?
Yes, you know, from the scriptures, we get a good look at the life of Paul. And of course, Paul was originally introduced in the Bible as Saul. Paul was a very educated man by Jewish law, tradition, and culture. He was doing everything that you would expect by Jewish custom to excel in the Jewish faith and nation at the time. He was well educated. He was, we see from the scripture, he was extremely intelligent. And he did everything by the strictest understandings of the law of the Jews at that time. So much so that when Jesus had appeared and had obtained a great following that was leading people in a different direction, Saul, who later became Paul, saw that as a threat, and he literally got letters and the authority to assault and attack what was emerging as Christianity at the time, to the point that he was leading people to prison.
Don't forget to pause. እንግዲህ የጳውሎስ ሐዋርያ ጳውሎስ ህይወቱ ወደ ኢየሱስ ሳይመጣ የነበረው ህይወትና ከዛ ከመጣ በኋላ የነበረው ህይወት ነው እያየን ያለ ነው። ህይወት ናይ ሐዋርያ ጳውሎስ ቅድሚ ና ክርስቶስ ምጽኡን ዳህራይ ምስመጸ ህይወቱ እንታይ ይመስል ነይሩ? ከምዝበሎ ፓስተር ብሌን ብናይ አይሁድ ሕግን ደንብን ምስዓበየ ቅንዓት ኣምላኽ ነይርዎ ዳሕራይ ግን ኣብ መንገዲ ክርስቶስ ከም ትጓነፎ ሶ ወን ሂ ኢንካውንተር ክራይስት ቢፎር ሂ ኢንካውንተር ክራይስት ዋት ካይን ካራክተር ዋት ካይን ቢሄቨር he had?
I would say that Paul's behavior before Christ would have been one that would have been very legalistic and very much an intellectual knowledge of the things of the Jewish faith, and perhaps things that would have been seen as very pious.
ስለዚህ መጀመሪያ ሐዋርያ ጳውሎስ ህግ አክባሪ በህግና በሃይማኖት ነክ የሆነ ነገር ነበር ከዛ ዕውቀት ነበረው ይሁን እንጂ ወደ ህይወት አልመጣም ቅድሚው ህጊ ህጋዊ ወይም ሃይማኖታዊ ፍልጠት ናይ ቃል አምላክ ግን ናብቲ ሐቅ ብርሃን ናብ ህይወት ዘይመጸ ነይሩ ማለት እዩ then what happened when he encountered Christ?
Paul, in carrying out what he believed was right by Jewish law with great zealousness, was carrying letters that gave him the authority to imprison Christians. And he encountered Jesus on the road to Damascus, that would be in modern day Syria. And Jesus spoke to him and said, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?
Selezi. መንገድ ላይ ኢየሱስ ሲያገኘው ለመግደል ለማሰር ከዛ ኢየሱስ ለምንድን ነው ምታሳድደይ ብሎ ጠየቀው ማለት አም መንገዲ አመንቲ ቀትል ከሳድድ እንደኸደኸሎ ወታ ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ አም መንገዲ ደማስቆ ምስተገልጸሉ ንምንታይ ኢኻ ሳኦል ሳኦል ኢሉ ምፀውዖ ንዓይ ተሳደኒ ዘለኻ Then what happened next?
In that encounter, Saul was blinded and he heard the voice of the Lord as the Lord spoke to him from heaven. And he even inquired, "Who are thou, Lord?" And Jesus said, "I am Christ Jesus, who you persecute," meaning that as you persecute Christians, you persecute me. And Paul saw at the time, realizing that the true God had spoken to him, inquired what he must do, and the Lord gave him instruction to follow his very word, that he would become a witness for him.
ያን ጊዜ ለምን ታሳደኛለህ ብሎ ኢየሱስ ሲናገረው ማለት ለአማኝ ክርስቲያን ክርስቶስን ለሚከተል ለሚያሳድድ ሰው ኢየሱስን ነው ያሳደደ ያለው ኢየሱስ ራሱ ለምን ታሳደኛለህ አለው ስለዚህ ንምንታይ ተሳደነለህ ንምንታይ ይሉህ ሀተ ሆሎ ማለት ነአማን ክርስቲያን ክርስቶስ ንስዕብ ሰብ ምስዳድ ንክርስቶስ ምስዳድ ማለት እዩ ስለዚህ ንምንታይ ይላ ሀተዎ ዳሕራይ ምላሽ ከሆነ ርእ ማለት እዩ then what happened after he encounters Christ his life when he changed what happened to him what kind of person came up
Paul became a totally different person. The very energy and with the same fervousness that he worked against the Christian faith, he now became a person touched by God and gave himself wholly to the things of the Lord Jesus Christ and to preaching and sharing his gospel. So much so that people were amazed by the change where he had persecuted the church and now he was preaching the very gospel and he gave himself totally to all that the Lord Jesus had shown him to do.
ስለዚ ከተቀየረ በኋላ ኢየሱስ ወደ ህይወቱ ከመጣ በኋላ ያ ሰው ተቀይሮ ዓላማው ተቀይሮ ድሮ ያሳደ የነበረውን አሁን ወንጌልን መስበክ ጀመረ ይውላችሁ አንድ ሰው ኢየሱስ ወደ ህይወቱ ሲገባ ከማሳደድ ወይም ሰውን ከመግደል እሱ ራሱ የሚሰደድ እሱ ራሱ የሚገደል ሆነ ድሮ ሰውን ለመግደል ተዋሪ ሆኖ ነበር አሁን ግን እስ ራሱ ከሚያሳደዋቸው እስ ራሱ ከሚጎላቸው አንድ ሆነ ሐደሰ ክርስቶስ ናዮት ከመጽኸሎ ቅድም ሕጂ ሐዋርያ ጳውሎስ ሰባት ቀጥል ከለው አው ሐቢሩ ነይሩ ሕጂ ግን ካፕቶም ንጎይታ ኢየሱስ ስዕቡ ዝቅተሉ ካብኦም ሓደ ኮይኑ ካብቶም ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ ስዕቡ ስደዱ እሱ ድማ ተሰዳዲ ኮይኑ ዘን ዊ ሰው ዘ አፖስቶል ሂዝ ላይፍ ቸንጅ ሂ ቢካም ፓይነር ሂ ቢካም the best example in the Bible. So that was briefly the life of Apostle Paul. Then, so when someone comes to Christ, Pastor Blaine, something happens to that person. There's something, a change, instant change. Can you tell me what are those instant change that happens to the person who comes to Christ?
You know, it's the most amazing miracle of all. Just like we saw in the life of Paul, any individual who comes to Jesus, they're changed instantly on the inside. The Bible describes that in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 as all things being made new. everything previously that was contrary to God is passed away. And their life is totally a new start, a new beginning. We sometimes refer to that as being born again. But they are in a relationship with God that is whole and complete and will change their life for eternity.
ስለዚህ አንድ ሰው ኢየሱስን ሲቀበል ምንድነው በህይወቱ የሚታየው? መጽሐፍ ቅዱስ እንደሚናገረን አዲስ ፍጥረት ይሆናል ይላል። በቆሮንቶስ 5:17 አዲስ ፍጥረት አዲስ ምንድነው? ከውስጡ ይለወጣል። ባህሪው ይቀየራል። የውስ መንፈሱ ህያው ይሆናል። ስለዚህ ሐደሰብ ናኩሰክ መጽሐፍሎ ናይውሽጢ ለውጢ ሐድሽ ፍጥረት ይሆን። ከላውንጥ 5:17 ሐድሽ ፍጥረት እንታዩ ናይውሽጢ ለውጢ ካውሽጢ ክርስትና ካውሽጢ ናብደከይ። ስለዚህ ሐድሽ ፍጥረት ሐድሽ ህይወት መንፈሱ ህያው ይሆን። ዘን ፓስተር ብሌን When someone comes to Christ, who is our model? A Christian, they need to look at the rest of their life. As long as they are on earth, who they need to look at? The reason I am asking you is, in our circle, especially right now in Ethiopia, there are a lot of chaos in the church. So, who is our model? The apostles? The pastors? The Pope? Or Christ Jesus? Who is our example? Who is our model we need to look at?
You know, the scripture is very clear about that, and I believe that it is clear in the scripture that Jesus said, follow me, that Jesus himself is our model. He is our example. Jesus came to show us the way that we are to be children of God. He did that by example, and then he gave us his spirit and washed us in his blood, so that we could follow in his example that he provided for us.
So we should not look for somebody else. We should just gaze our attention to Christ. You see, sundalo Jesus no tekatelenyalo hawar aidellem nabiyat aidellem pastor aidellem pope aidellem Jesus no tekatelay selezi ስትከተል ማየት ያለብህ ኢየሱስ ነው። እሱ ላይ እንከን የለም። እሱ ላይ ምንም ነውር የለም። እሱ ነው ማየት ያለብህ። ኢየሱስ ሰዓቡኒ ኢሉ አው ሐዋርያ አይሆንን ፓስራት አይኮንን ነቢያት አይኮንን ኢየሱስ ይው ሰዓበኒ ዘበለ ሰዓበኒ ክስዕብ ከለኻ ዓይንትኻ ሓሳብካ ልብኻ ኩሉ አቅልቦኻ ናብቱ አበር ዘይብሉ እንታ ዘይብሉ ሕፍት ዘይብሉ የሱስ ወዲ ኣምላኽኻ ዓይንትኻ ክትገብር ዝግባኣካ ኣብኢኻ ጌጋ ይትረክብ ኣብኡ ኣበር ይትረክብን ኢኻ ሕፍቲ ዘይብሉ ወዲ ኣምላኽ። ስለዚ ሰባት ዝወድቁ ሰባት ዝዕንቀፉ ኣብ ሰብ ክርእዩ ከለዉ እዮም። ዓይንትኻ ናብቲ ናይ እምነት ካን ጀማርን ፈፃምን ዝኾነ የሱ ወዲ ኣምላኽ ናብኡ ኣድግ። ሶ ዊ ኒድ ቱ ፎከስ ኦን ክራይስት ኖባዲ ኤልስ ሂ ኢዝ ዘ ኦልቲሜት ፐርፌክት ዘ ሳን ኦፍ ዘ ሊቪንግ ጋድ። ፓስተር ብሌን ማይ ኔክስት ኮስቸን ኢዝ ዚስ What is, I'm going to a little bit shift the question. What is the number one humanity disease? A, coronavirus. B, HIV. C, cancer. D, tumor. E, sin. Separation, man from God. Go ahead.
Well, without a doubt, sin is the problem that humanity faces that only Jesus himself can deliver us from. All sickness, all disease, all things that are contrary to God are a result of sin. And sin itself is what separates us from God. That's why the sacrifice that God made through his son is so critical for humanity, because Jesus alone by his blood redeems us and delivers us from the power of sin.
ስለዚህ የሰው ቀዳሚ የሰው ዘር ቀዳሚ ችግር ኃጢአት ነው። ኮሮና ቫይረስ አይደለም ካንሰር አይደለም ኤችአይቪ አይደለም ኃጢአት ነው ሰው ከእግዚአብሔር የለየው። ስለዚህ ለዚህ ነው የዓለም መድኃኒት መድኃኒ ዓለም የተላከው። ስለዚህ ናይሰብ ቀዳሚ ቀዳምነት ጸገም ህማም ኃጢአት ነው ሰብ ካብ አምላክ ዘፈለየው። ኮሮና ቫይረስ አይኮንን ካንሰር አይኮንን ኤችአይቪ አይኮንን ኃጢአት ነው ሰብ ካብ እግዚአብሔር ዘፈለየው። ንዑን እግዚአብሔር ወዱ ሊኢኹ መድሃኒ ሊኢኹ ነዚዩ መድሃኒ ዓለም ዝበልናዮ ንኢየሱስ። ኦኬ ኔክስት ኳስችን ፓስተር ብሌን፣ ኢፍ ሲን ኢዝ ዘ ነምበር ዋን ፕሮብለም ፎር ማንካይንድ፣ ኢፍ ክራይስት ኢዝ ዘ ኦንሊ ሴቨር ፎር ማንካይንድ፣ why is the body of Christ having no passion for new souls? Why no passion? In a way, I am asking this question. I see some people, some preachers, they will be preaching in a big, having a big meeting, 15,000, 20,000 at the end of their preaching without inviting a new soul for Christ, they will hand the mic to the pastor. Why is that? I don't understand. Do you have, can you explain to me?
I think one of the biggest challenges that humanity faces, and it shows up in the body of Christ, is complacency and the ability to lose fervency for the things of God. Not by choice, but by choices, and by people becoming so familiar and so comfortable with the things, I believe, this of this world, that it causes our fire for God to wane, to where it has to be rekindled. And I think that shows up even in our churches and in our services of even great masses, like you've said. Jesus said, if someone were to gain the whole world and lose their soul, it profits them nothing. The winning of souls is the very reason that Jesus came and established his church. There's no excuse for not presenting the gospel to the multitudes when that's the very thing Jesus told us to go into all the world and do.
ስለዚህ ጥያቄ ጠይቁት ምን ነበር? ኢየሱስ እሱ ብቻ አዳኝ ከሆነ የዓለም ችግር የሰው ዘር ችግር ኃጢአት ከሆነ ታዲያ ለምንድን ነው ቤተክርስቲያን አማኞች ኢየሱስን የማይሰብኩት? ለምንድን ነው ለአዲስ ነብሳት ጥማት የሌላቸው? አንዳንድ ሰባኪዎች ትልቅ ጉባኤ ያላቸው በተለይ 15,000-20,000 ከሰበኩ በኋላ መጨረሻ ላይ ነብሳትን ጥሪ ሲያደርጉ ማይኩን ለፓስተሩ ወይ ለመሪው ይሰጣሉ ምንድን ነው ፓሽኑ ይጠፋ አልኩት እሱም ምን አለ ምክንያቱም የዓለም ምኞት ምቾት እንዲሁም በቤተክርስቲያን ያለው መመሰቃቀል አላማ መጥፋት የምድር ድሎት ምቾት ተነሳ ያን ጠፋ ይላል ሕቱ ተሓተትኩ ሕቶሲ ክርስቶስ በይኑ መድሓን እንት ኮይኑ ብጀካ የሱስ ካሊእ መድሓን እንተ ዘየለ እንተ ኮይኑ ሓጢኣት ናይ ዓለም ናይ ነብሲ ወከፍ ናይ ደቂ ሰባት ፀገም እንተ ኮይኑ ንምንታይ እዮም ሰባት ኣመንቲ ክርስትያናት ወንጌል ወይ ናይ ነብሳት ፅምኢ ዘይብሎም ገሊኦም ሰባት 10,000 15,000 ኣብ ተኣከበሉ ወንጌል ሰቢኹም ኣብ መጨረሻ ነብሳት ናብ ኣምላኽ ይፀውዑ እቲ ማይክ ነቲ መራሒ ክህብዎ እቲ ማይክ ነቲ ፓስተር ክህብዎ ይርኢ መልሱ ፓስተር ብሌን እንታይ ይብላሎ ምክንያቱም ናይ ዓለም ናብራ ጣዕሚ ናብራ ናይ ዓለም ቤተ ኣምላኽ ማሕበረ ኣምላኽ ተሓዊስዎ ኣሎ እቲ ዓላማ ጠፊእዎ ኣሎ ይብላሎ ስለዚ ኣብ ፅቡቕ ናብራ ዘሎ ነቲ ናይ ዓላማ ስሒቱ ብዛዕባ ነብሳት ዘለዎ ፅምኣት እንዳቐነሰ ኸይዱ ይብላሎ ወል Pastor Blaine, what is the purpose of, the primary purpose of the body of Christ here on this planet Earth? What's the purpose?
You know, I think we can sum up the whole purpose of the church in this hour and ever since Jesus established his church as twofold. And in the Great Commission of Jesus, we see this. In one sense, he told us to go and make disciples of men, to baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, that they might come into his body, that they might be saved. And then he told us to go and preach the gospel to every nation. In other words, to compel the nations to repent and to turn to Jesus. For Jesus said, I am the only way to be saved. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. So to sum up, to reach the world with the gospel that people might be saved, and then to disciple them in the ways of Christ.
ፓስብልን እንደመለሰው ሂዱ የሚለውን ዋናው የወንጌል ተልእኮ መፈጸም ነው አለ መስበክ ነው አለ ንብሳትን ወደ እግዚአብሔር መምጣት ደቀ መዝሙር ማድረግ ትሕቶ ቤተ አምላክ ወይ ማህበረ አምላክ አሁን ምድር ዘላ ቀዳሚ ወይ ቀዳማይ ወይ እቲ መጀመርተ ዓላማ እንታይ እዩ ዝብል እዩ ትመልሱ ፓስተር ብሌን ከም ዝመለሶ ኪዱ ወንጌል ፍጥረት ኩሉ ሰበኩ ተባህለ ንፍጻሚ እዩ ሽዑ ደቂ መዝሙር ምግባር እዩ ኢሉ ማለት እዩ ፓስተር ብሌን ኣይ ማይ ኣድድ ዋን ሞር ኣይ ማይ ኣድድ ዋን ሞር የስ ነምበር ዋን ኢዝ ጎይ The Great Commission, which is Matthew 16, verse 13. Then Matthew 28, to make disciple for Christ. Number three, the purpose of, the primary purpose of the body of Christ is, number three, we see it on Ephesians chapter 4, verse 13. It says, to train and equip the believers. Train them to accuse them.
Yes.
Why? To make them to become like the unity of faith.
Yes.
The harmony of faith.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, on that purpose, to come all of us in the knowledge of the Son of God.
Yes. Amen.
And to become mature, attain the whole fullness of Christ. That is threefold.
Yes.
We preach the gospel to make disciples and to equip saints. Train them to make them whole.
Yes.
The fullness of Christ. ምንድን ነው አላማው ስንል ሶስት አላማ የያዘ ነው ክርስቲያን በምድር ያለችው ዋናው ቀዳሚ ሶስት አላማ ይዟል አንደኛ ሰዎችን ወደ እግዚአብሔር መንግስት ማምጣት ሂዱ የተባለው ወንጌል ስበኩ ያለው ጌታ ሂዱ ያለው ጌታ ተመለሱ አላለም አሁንም ያ ቃል እንዳለ ነው ሂዱ ሁለተኛ ደቀ መዝሙር ማድረክ ማፍራት ሶስተኛ በኤፌሶን 4:13 የጻፈው ቃል ወደ አንድነት ወደ እምነት አንድነት ለማምጣት ያም በእግዚአብሔር ልጅ ዕውቀት እንዲሁም ወደ ሙሉ ሰው ለማድረስ ፍጹም ሰው ክርስቶስን የሚመስል ሰው ለማምጣት ነው ዓላማ ናይ ማህበር አምላክ ናይ ክርስቶስ አምድሪ ምህላዋ ሰለስተ ዘሐዘይ ቀዳማይ ኪዱ ተባሃለ ወንጌል ጸብኹሞ እቲ ኪዱ ዘበለ ጎይታ ተመለሶ አይበለን ኪዱ አባርቆስ ወንጌል 16 ፍቅዲ 13 ዘሎ ኪዱ ከመሆን ደቀ መዛሙርት ምግባር ደቀ መዛሙርት ምፍራይ ሳልሳይ አብ ኢፌሶን 4 ፍቅዲ 13 ዘሎ ናብ እምነት ሓድነት ሓደ ንምግባር ዩኒቲ ኦፍ ፌዝ ይብሎ ሃርመኒ ኦፍ ፌዝ ካልኣያውኡ እንታይ ይብሎ ናብ ፍልጠት ወደ ኣምላኽ ንመፅእ ከምኡውን ውርድ ይልዋኦ ናፍቲ ሙሉእ ሰብ ሆልነስ ፉልነስ እን ክራይስት ንምፃ እዩ ወይ ድማ ብሱል ብቑዕ ዝኾነ ሰብ ንምፃ እዩ ፓስተር ብሌን So I think our time is about to end. I don't know if we're going to continue because let's just wrap it for today.
You know, the things that are going on our planet are a constant reminder that the human race needs God more than anything. And we see evidence of this, not just through the global pandemic that's going on now, but by many other indicators that the return of the Lord is at hand. Jesus himself said in Matthew 24 that there would be many signs of his coming. And there are things that he uses examples like wars and rumors of wars and natural disasters and pestilence, which is various forms of disease and sickness like we see today. But without a doubt, the things that are stretching our resources and other things on this planet are clear indicators that we need an intervention from God as a human race. That's the very reason that Jesus came. He came that he might make all things new, starting with us, that his desire is that none would perish, but that all would come to repentance. It's the very reason that he hung on that cross. And how fitting on this weekend as we celebrate Easter, the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, that we would be having this very discussion about how to give our lives to Jesus. You may be listening to this broadcast today, and you've been wondering about your own life. You've been concerned about the things you see and what the future holds. But the Bible's very clear that Jesus alone holds the future for us, that he desires that we would come into a saving knowledge with him. He created us. He gave us the very breath of life, and he gives us the very way to enjoy the life that he gave. John 10:10 says that Jesus came that we might have life and that more abundantly. It's the thief that comes to steal and to kill and to destroy. But Jesus said, I've come that you might have life. He said that all who follow after him, who call upon him, shall be saved. So I would ask you today, if you don't know Jesus in a personal way, if you've never invited him into your heart to be your Savior and your Lord, would you do that today? The Bible says today is the day of salvation. Jesus stands at the door of your heart knocking, waiting for you to invite him in. He is the Savior. He is the only way to be saved. Would you do that today if you have not accepted Jesus as your Savior? Pray this prayer with me. Jesus,
yes.
I ask you this day to come into my heart. Be my Savior and be my Lord. Thank you, Jesus, that you shed blood for me, that I might be cleansed, healed, and made whole. This day I give my life to you, and I thank you for washing me of all sin and cleansing me of all unrighteousness. Jesus, come into my heart and be my Savior and be my Lord. You know, the Bible says if you pray that prayer, if you make that invitation from a sincere heart and invite the Lord into your life, that you are saved. There's a book in heaven, and that book is real, and it's called the Lamb's Book of Life. And when one person repents, gives their life to Jesus, the Bible says that all heaven rejoices and that that individual's name is recorded in that book. If you prayed that prayer today and you believed, you are saved. Your name is recorded eternally in heaven. And we rejoice with you that you this day have given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Samawaraji. ንሰማያለሁ ምናልባት አሁን በኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ ያለው ብዙ ይጆረኮብሮ የሚቀድ ስለከስና የሰማ ይሆናል ይሁን እንጂ እነቱ ክርስቶስ አሁንም አዳኝ እንደሆነ እሱ የሚያምን ነው የዓለም ህይወት የሚያገኘው ክርስትና እንጤ አይደለችም ክርስቶስ እንጤ አይደለም ክርስቶስ በመስቀል ላይ የሞተው ሰዎችን ለማዳን ነው ክርስትና ህይወት ናት እንጤ አይደለችም ከንሽ አይደለችም ኦርቶዶክስ አይደለችም ክርስትና ህይወት ናት ለዚህ ነው ክርስቶስ በመስቀል ላይ ሞተው ይሄን እውነታ በማንኛውም የሃይማኖት ካባ ቢሸፈነው ሊሸፈን አይችልም። ክርስቶስ ለሰው ሁሉ ኃጢአት ሞተ። እሱ ያመነ በመላው ዓለም የሰው ዘር ሁሉ ላመነ እሱን ለተቀበለ የኃጢአት ስርየት ላገኘ ሕይወት ያገኛል። ከዛ ባሻገር በማንም ተአምር በምን ተአምር ያ ሰው ሕይወት ሊያይ ይችላል። ስማ ሐወይ ናልባት ሕጂ ያ ኢትዮጵያ ሰምዑ ዘለኻ ኸወረ ዝንኻዝ ዝቀድድ ብዙሕ ዘዋኽዕ ብዛዕባ ክርስትና ሰሚዕኻ ኸውን ይኽእል። ግናኸ ተሓቂ ሓቂ እዩ። ክርስቶስ ጴንጥ ኣይኮነን፣ ክርስቶስ ኦርቶዶክስ ኣይኮነን፣ ክርስቶስ ከንሽ ኣይኮነን። ክርስቶስ ህይወት እዩ። ክርስትና ጴንጥ ኣይኮነትን እያ፣ ከንሽ ኣይኮነትን እያ፣ ኦርቶዶክስ ኣይኮነትን እያ። ክርስትና ህይወት እያ። ነዚ እዩ ጎይታ የሱስ ክርስቶስ መምፅኡ ዕላማ ክዛረብ ከሎ መምፅኢ ዕላማ ኢሉ ኣብ ዮሃንስ 10:10 ህይወት ክህበኩም ህይወት ምስ ርፍኾኩም መፃእኹ ኢሉ። ስለዚ መምፅኡ ሃይማኖት ስለሰኣና ኣይኮነን፣ ህይወት ስለሰኣና ህይወት ክበና መፅኡ። ስማዕ ሓወይ ኣብ ዘለካየ ቦታ ተንበርከኽ ኢድካ ናብ ሰማይ ዘርግሕ ሞ ወጎይታይ ይቕረ በለለ ይበሎ። ሰብ ሓንሳብ ንሞት ዳሕራይ ድማ ናብ ፍርዲ ይብሎ ቃል ኣምላኽ። ካብ ፍርዲ ክወፅእ ዝኽእል ድማ ብናይ ክርስቶስ ደም እዩ። ስለዚ ሃቭ መርሲ ኦን ሚ በሎ። ተንበርከ ወዳጄ ሃቭ መርሲ ኦን ሚ በለው። እግዚአብሔር ኣምላኽና ስሙ ዝተመስገነ ዝተባረኸ ይኹን። Pastor Blaine, probably we have to cover the rest next week if we can, fast possible. And thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome.
And I know you are 2 hours behind in Arizona. May the Lord bless you. God bless you. We're going to play this song until for a few minutes, and we're going to end up.
Amen. Thank you. It was a pleasure being here.
እንግዲህ አምስሰሙ በዓለም ዙሪያ እግዚአብሔር አምላካችን ስሙ የተመሰገነ የተባረከ ይሁን። ስለሰማችሁ ጌታ ይባርካችሁ። በዚህ ትንሣኤ ጊዜ ሞትን በማሰብ ያሳለፈው መንገላታት በማሰብ ያንን በቀደመ ሳነብ መጽሐፍ ቅዱስን ሳነብ ልቤን በእንባ ሰበረው። አዝ በጣም አለቀስኩኝ። ያ ምንድን ነው? ኢየሱስን ቱፍ ሲሉበት ሲቶፍበት በዛ ቢያዙት ምርኩዝ ወይ ደግሞ ከዘራ ራሱን ሲመቱት፣ ያ ሁሉ ለእኔ ነው ያደረገው፣ ያ ሁሉ ላንተ ነው። ዝሓለፈ ሰሙን ኢየሱስ ገበሮ ከንብብ ከለኹ ጡፍ ኢሎምሉ ብዘንጊ ርእሱ ወቂዐሞ ኣዜ በኺ። እዚ ኩሉ እኮ ንዓይኻ ጌርካዮ፣ እዚ ኩሉ ንዓይ ጌርካዮ ኢየሱስ። ክሳብ ሞት ብምኻድ እሙን ብምዃን ክሳብ ሞት ተኣሚኑ እዚ ኩሉ ዝገበሮ ንዓይን ንዓኻን እዩ። ስለዚ ብምስትብሃል ነዚ ብሩኽ ጎይታ ካብ ዝመፅእ ቁጣዓ፣ ካብ ዝመፅእ መከራ፣ ካብ ዝመፅእ ኩሉ ከልሕልና እዩ። እዚ ኩሉ ሓሊፉ ስለዚህ ይመጻሉ ግዜ ተወድዩሎ ረሳቀና አብል ኢየሱስ ይመጻሉ ግዜ ተወድዩ ሃሌሉያ
Me, Jesus, take me now.
Surrender to you.
Amen.
I surrender to you. My Savior, surrender. Salam. Shalom.
Jesus. Surrender me. Me Savior. Holy God. My hope is me.
Stuart from Guatemala. Shalom, shalom, shalom. I see Stuart from Guatemala. Muchas gracias. God bless you. I see that Pastor Blaine probably remembers us, Stuart from Guatemala.
Yes, of course.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Well, this is for today. God bless you, Pastor Blaine, again. We're going to
thank you.